Hello friends, I am Mr. Ravindra Bhalerao and I welcome you to my channel that is English for Learners. Dear students, in today's video we shall discuss about the question bank of English subject first language which is provided by SSC Board Maharashtra Education Department. So this one is the first video of this question bank, that is language study, which you will get the activities with their answers. But before watching this video, as usual, I request you, don't forget to subscribe my channel. Alright, let's begin to discuss about question bank. Standard 10 subject English first language, March 2021. This one is the English activity sheet number 1. Now let's begin section 1, that is language study. As you know that activities related to the language studies are grammatical activities. Let's begin first question. Question number 1A. A1. Do as directed any 4 for 4 marks. You will be given 6 activities. Out of 6, 4 activities should be correct. Then you will get 4 marks. Let's see number 1. Make meaningful sentence by using the given phrase the quest of freedom. Here you have given one phrase, that is the quest of freedom, and this phrase you have to use in your own sentence. Okay, so first of all you should know the meaning of quest of freedom. Quest of freedom means to struggle for freedom. Yes, the quest for freedom means to struggle for freedom. Let's see the answer, which is given by using the phrase the quest for freedom. It's really a story about the human quest for freedom and safety, Mr. Mao said. Or another way, we can give one more example. Our freedom fighters sacrificed their lives for the quest for freedom. So this type of sentence we can construct. Let's see next activity number 2. Form 2 present participles in which the last letter is doubled. As you know, the present participle or gerund. So here the answer, we shall see the answer. Here the answer of present participle where the last letter is double. Blogging, double G is there, last letter. Blog, blogging. Plan, planning. So these are the examples of present participles in which the last letter is doubled. Next activity number 3. Pick out the gerund. The sentence is given here. He enjoys painting during his spare time. He enjoys painting during his spare time in this sentence, which is the gerund. So as you know that here painting, and so let's see the answer. Painting is the gerund. It is a object of. Let's see next activity number 4. Identify the kind of sentence. The sentence is given here. Summon the police. Summon means call. Calling. Summon the police. Police. So identify the kind of sentence. It means which type of sentence it is. So as you know that the sentence begin with summon, which is the verb. So this sentence is an imperative sentence. ज्याला आपण मराठीमध्ये आज्ञार्थी वाक्य म्हणतो. नेक्स्ट ऍक्टिव्हिटी नंबर 5. स्पॉट द एरर ऑर एरर्स अँड रीराइट द सेंटेन्स. यू विल बी गिवन दिस टाइप ऑफ सेंटेन्स. जस्ट सी द सेंटेन्स. शी गिव मी द इम्प्रेशन ऑफ हॅविंग मोर टीथ. सो इन दिस सेंटेन्स यू हॅव टू फाइंड आउट द एरर and rewrite by correcting that error. So here the answer is given like this. She gave me the impression of having more teeth. Next, A2, Duez directed any 2 for 4 marks. Number 1, the sentence is given, I found that I had only enough for a small tip. And identify the clause. So in this given sentence, which clause is used? So here, let's see the answer. There are two clauses, main clause, that is I found. Main clause is I found, and subordinate clause or noun clause we can say, that is that I had only enough for a small tip. This one is a subordinate clause of noun, or just we can say noun clause. Next activity, number 2. The sentence is given like this. Robert said to John, have you ever seen English soldier fighting? Rewrite in indirect speech. Change the narration, or we have to change the given direct speech sentence to indirect speech. The answer is given, as you might have learnt about direct and indirect speech, how to convert or transfer the direct speech to indirect speech. Now just see the answer. Robert asked John if she had ever seen English soldier fighting. Next sentence, next activity is number 3. He shared his room with a boy suffering from leukemia. So here is asked for change into past perfect continuous tense. So the given sentence we have to change into past perfect continuous tense. You should know the formulas of past perfect continuous tense. Subject plus had been plus verb dash ing, like this. Let's see the just answer. He had been sharing his room with a boy suffering from leukemia. Next activity, question number 1B, Duez directed anyone for 2 marks. 1. Use the following word as a noun and as verb in 2 different sentences. Here the word guide is given. You have to use this guide word as a noun as well as a verb. So you have to construct 2 different separate sentences. Let's see the answer. The word guide as a noun, and the sentence is, we hired a guide for our trip to the mountains. Next sentence, by using guide as a verb, that is, I will guide you. Here the word guide is used as a verb. Next activity, that's last one, number 3. The sentence is given here. He is one of the most intelligent persons in the group. Change the degree. So this sentence you have to change the degree, any one of the degree, whether it is positive degree or comparative degree. Actually this sentence is given in superlative degree. Here this sentence you can change either positive degree or comparative degree. In the both of the sentence I have given here as a, let's see the, as a positive degree. Very few persons in group are as intelligent as he. And as a comparative degree, he is more intelligent than most other persons in the group. Now you might have said that how this answer is given here. If you want to know more about the degree, how the degree, the sentence change superlative to positive or comparative, you can watch the video of change the degree. So friends, I hope you might have liked this video. If you liked it, please share it. If you have any suggestions for me, you can write in comment box. The remaining activities I will cover in next video. So wish you good day. Take care. Thank you very much.